Hi, you guys, and welcome to week 12. This is 11A. I really enjoyed reading your six-letter descriptions of this year. That was fun to look at. And if you allow me, I will post them. So if you don't want me to post yours, let me know. If not, I'm just going to do a big posting of lots of those examples and without any names on them. So they should be fine, I think. One thing I want to comment on this week, with the homework that, I think there is some confusion as to what fitness means. So many of you got it absolutely right and others were confused. And so I wanted to clear that up. So in biology, when we talk about fitness, we're talking about the ability of a living organism to leave lots of offspring in the next generation. That's what being fit is. So I was looking at my oak trees now that are leaving hundreds of acorns. This is one of those years where they just went crazy. That is fitness. It's leaving so many offspring in the next year that essentially you're leaving your genes in the next population. So it doesn't mean being big and strong. It means, are you successful at surviving, reproducing, and leaving offspring in the next generation? So that's how we think of it's very important in biology, because that's how organisms are going to do well. Are they going to succeed? Are they leaving offspring to the point that they're going to survive? Or are the numbers diminishing in their population because they haven't been doing very well and their fitness is lowered? So very important today when we're talking about extinction of so many animals, of animals hurting because they don't have habitat and various other problems where their fitness has declined. They are maladapted and they're not leaving a great number of offspring in the next generation. So that's fitness as we define it in biology and not in the weight room. Okay, so I wanted to clear that up. I'm going to be grading this week your drawings, and hopefully you paid attention to detail. I know that when I started doing that, I started to notice things that I'd never ever noticed before. For example, I was drawing a cone from a redwood, a little tiny cones, and I started to notice that I could never find a seed inside them. There was never a seed, and I thought, I wonder why this cone, the whole purpose of a cone is to disperse some of these seeds, and why do I never find a seed? So I started to investigate that. I looked it up and I learned that the seed drops up to 2 years before the cone drops. So there's no way that if this had dropped cone that I was going to find a seed. So we start to notice so many things when you start to draw and really look. So that's why I had to do that exercise, and I've started grading them, but I haven't gotten to a lot of them yet. So that will be interesting. So have a good week, you guys, and I'll see you soon.